Hi, my name is Ron Fieldhouse. I'm the curriculum specialist here at PASCO Scientific.
And I'm Tom Lescavo, education manager here at PASCO. And we're here today to introduce the wireless voltage sensor.
I'm going to take it out of the box for you. All right, first thing I noticed that my wireless sensor does have wires. All right, the first wire, let me take it out here. That's the wireless sensor itself. Let me put it there. This is the USB cable. And since this is rechargeable, that's how you charge it. You can also use this to collect data at very fast sample rates. All right, the other wires inside the box are actually leads. And if you know about electricity, you obviously need leads to measure things. All right, I'm placing the black one in the black hole, the red one in the red hole. Now, it does say positive and negative, so I now know that the red one is the positive end and the black one is the negative. All right, to turn this on, I'm just going to hold the button down just for a moment. I see the red light over here flashed. Now the Bluetooth light is flashing, telling me it's ready to pair with SparkView.
So now I can pair to SparkView. So in SparkView, I'm going to touch my Bluetooth icon. It's going to find the sensors in the room. There's a voltage sensor. I see the ID number here and on the device to make sure I'm pairing to the right one. Now that it's connected, I see a green battery indicator here and a indicator over here, so that's connected. I'm gonna hit done, and I'm ready to go. So on my home screen, I now see a voltage of 0, which is what I would expect. And to do this particular experiment, we're gonna look at batteries and batteries in a series. I'm gonna use a meter display. So I'm gonna touch on voltage, and I'm gonna go through my graph display, my digits, my table, and I get to a meter display. Now, to make this a little more usable in the video, I'm going to change my range of my voltage readings. I'm going to go in here into my tools for that meter. I'm going to turn off auto scale to fit and go from -5 to +5 volts. So now I'm ready.
All right, I'm going to connect the leads, the positive end to the top of the battery and the negative to the bottom. There, I'm holding it on her. There we go.
And we're getting around a positive 1.5 volts.
Okay, now your students might accidentally hook it up the wrong way, which is what I'm going to do. And when that happens,
now I get a negative 1.5 volts.
Awesome.
So now we can know not only from the sensor what's plus and minus, but and the battery what's plus and minus, but from the measurements what's plus and minus.
Now I know some devices require more than one battery.
Why is that?
We want to increase the voltage. So I'm going to connect two batteries and show you what happens to the voltage.
Let's see. So now instead of 1.5, now I have a little bit over 3 volts.
Okay, and I've got a third battery I'm going to slide in and connect that. There we go.
And now we're a little over 4.5 volts. So every time we added one, we added about 1.5 volts.
Awesome.
So this is a great activity to introduce batteries and circuits. You can also use the wireless voltage sensor for electrochemical cells. And if you want to do faster sampling rate, the wirelessly it'll support 1,000 hertz, but using the USB connection, you can get up to 100,000 hertz for your fast sampling circuits experiments. So this has been an introduction to the wireless voltage sensor. If you want to learn more, you can go to pasco.com/wireless. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.